Hello everyone, I am Anjali, Assistant Professor from Chitkara School of Hospitality. In today's session, we will talk about training in the housekeeping department. So we start on with the training, a simple definition of a training. Training is an overall enhancement of human ability by developing knowledge, skills, attitude and behaviors in order to achieve individual goals. Training relates not only to the new employee, but it is ongoing process for the entire team. Training is efficient only when the knowledge gained is applied at work and tested for usefulness. In the second picture, we see the retention of information. The retention of information says about the different senses and the information retained. By seeing, we retain 75% information, hearing it is 13%, feeling it is 6%, smelling it is 3%, tasting it is 3%. The first training in the housekeeping department. The first training of a new employee actually starts with the continuation of a department orientation. When a new employee is turned over the housekeeping or environmental service department, orientation usually continues by familiarizing the employee with the department rules and regulations. A systematic approach of a training. Training may be defined as those activities that are designed to help an employee begin performing tasks for which he or she is hired to help the employee improve performance in the job already assigned. In housekeeping, various training is involved, which is skill training, attitude training, guidance training. So we start on with the skill training. Various skill training which is required as a physical part of the housekeeping. So first one is your bed making. The bed making is one should know or understand about how to make a bed, the various steps of a bed making, and where to start, where to finish with the all proper standard of a bed making. The second one is the vacuuming. The technique involved where to start, where to stop, and how to take care of the particular vacuuming and what are the areas where you need to do the vacuuming. The third important is in the skill trainings are dusting. The various technique of doing the dusting, which involves top to bottom level. This is all been learned in the training. Window and a mirror cleaning, which is again a technique and a product cleaning, which is being set up by the individual with the help of a training. Setup awareness, that includes room setup, washroom setup, or a bathroom or any other area setups in the hotel. Coming with the sixth one, that is a bathroom training again, which involves all the bathroom training which is being done by where to place the amenities, where we need to place the correct supplies in the bathroom. The seventh one is daily routine. In order to work on a daily basis, the daily routine training is important. So skill training also helps to develop an individual to know about the various training. Caring for and using equipment. Various caring and the use of equipment is done on the skill training. Industrial safety training, which is also included in a skill training, where as a person comes to know about guest safety and security according to the various emergency situations or a fire situation or any disastrous situation. It is also a part of a skill training. Next one is attitude training or attitude guidance training. Employee need a guidance in their attitude about the work that must be done. They need to be guided in their thinking about rooms that may present as a unique problem in the cleaning. Attitude guidance involves employee towards a guest, how he talks, how he speaks, or how he takes his feedback, or how he takes his preferences in the department. How he speaks to the manager, how he speaks to the supervisors is also part of an attitude guidance. the hotel and the company policies, whereas a person should know, or a person, an employer should understand about the company policies or a hotel policy. About the uniform, that is also an absolute guidance about how appearance, how he looks like, or is he properly groomed or not, or is he going in front of a guest with the proper grooming. So these are all the attitude guidance, the personal hygiene, which is must in the department. And a person needs to be proper hygiene, as in with the proper grooming. So that also includes the attitude guidance. Benefits of a training. The benefits of training are as follows. A new employee learns in a comfortable atmosphere. The new employees understand the importance of a job and expectations to be met. Existing employees improve their work performance. Flexibility is incorporated due to the cross training. The guidance of the accident is reduced and safety is enhanced. It reduces the expenditure on the maintenance of a machine result. Employees are motivated and their job satisfaction improved. Employees and overall productivity improves. Employee turnover is reduced. The executive housekeepers gets more time for a management activities. The standard and a quality of a work improves. Supervisions improve. More profit flow and the due to the better business. Next are the various training methods which is opted in the housekeeping. So various training methods which includes, there are 8 methods. The first one is on-the-job training, second off-the-job training, lecture, conferences, demonstration. The third one is stimulation training, fourth induction training, fifth refreshers training, sixth remedial training, seventh cross training, and eighth coach public training method. So the next chapter we will continue with the training methods. For this, I sign up. Thank you so much.